Welcome to first PO online classes. Students, today we will discuss the numericals on laws of motion chapter. Right, first numerical, see on the board here. A retarding force of 50 newton is applied to a body of mass 20 kg moving initially with speed 50 meter per second. How long does the body take to stop? Means how much taking time taking for the stopping the body. Here see once again problem. A retarding constant retarding force means the force value decreases. Retarding nothing but what is there? Decreasing. Acceleration is decreasing. So that force I am writing here, first problem solution here. Now force F equal to how much given? 50 newton given. But I am taken as a minus. By taking minus means retarding. Now applied to a body of mass 20 kg, mass M is equal to how many kg here? 20 kg, moving initially with the speed of 50 meter per second. Initial speed given u is taken as the initial speed. U is equal to 15 meter per second. Right, what are the given values? Here retarding force given minus 50 newton, mass given 20 kg, and speed given 15 meter per second. Initial speed is given. How long does the body take to stop? Body is stopping. Means it is moving with some velocity, stopped. Stopped means final velocity is 0. Initial velocity u equal to 15 meter per second, final velocity v equal to 0. First writing the given values, clear. Now in this question time is asking here. Time is asking means force is equal to what is the formula here? Mass into acceleration. Now force is equal to minus 50 here. Here of this formula again I am changing like this. F is equal to m into acceleration can be written as v minus u by t. Here change in the velocity by time, that is the formula for the acceleration. Now force is equal to minus 50 is equal to mass 20, final velocity 0, initial velocity 50. Here time we don't know, we have to find the time value. Right, 20 into 0 minus 15 by t. Here minus 50 is equal to, here 20 into minus 15 by t. Right, t taking this side, minus 50 taking this side, or simply you can make like this also, easily. Here minus 50 is equal to 50 to the 30 is 300, minus 300 by t. Here what is here, both sides minus minus cancel, 50 is equal to 300 by t. Right, t is equal to, I am taking here, this is taking this. Here written in 50 and t values, t equal to 300 by 50, 51 za, 56 za. Now what is here, how many seconds of time? 6 seconds of time. Right, means the time t equal to 60 seconds. Once again listen, a constant retarding force is how much money are 50 newton. Retarding means a minus. Mass of the body given 20 kg. Initial speed of 50 meter per second. How long does the body take to stop? Means the body is stopping. Stopping means final velocity automatically is 0. So force is equal to formula ma. F equal to m into acceleration change in the velocity v minus u by t. Now force, retarding force means already know that minus 50, mass is 20. Here final velocity 0, initial velocity 50, 0 minus 15 by t. Minus 50 is equal to 20 into minus 50 by t. Now minus 50 is equal to 15 to 30, means total value becomes 300 by t. Minus minus getting cancel, 50 is equal to 300 by t. T is equal to 300 by 50. Here this is 0 cancel, 5 6 30, or how many seconds of time here?
6 seconds of time.
Here how much time is taken for body stop? Here 6 seconds of time is taken for the body stop. Here this is a 6 seconds answer. Right, this is the first numerical. Next to we go to the here second numerical.
Right.
See the second numerical.
A constant force acting on a body of mass.
A constant force acting on a body of mass
3.0 kg. Body of mass given. A constant force is acting on a body of mass 3.0 kg. Changes its speed from 2.0 meter per second to 3.5 meter per second in 25 seconds. The direction of motion of the body remains unchanged. What is the magnitude and direction of the force? Means here direction of the motion of the body remains unchanged, means the force also acting in the same direction. The force direction cannot be changes. The force direction always in the direction of the motion of the body, because the motion of the body remains unchanged is given here. Clearly. Yes, means what is we have to find here? Magnitude. Just we have to find the magnitude, because
the force direction in the same direction of the motion of the body.
Now, a constant force acting on a body of mass, how much given? 3.0 kg given. Mass given. Here, mass is given. How much here? M equal to 3.0 kg. Nothing but 3 kg. Now its speed changes from 2.0 meter per second to 3.5 meter per second. Means initial speed equal to 2.0 meter per second. Next, final speed 3.5 meter per second. Means its speed is changes from 2.0 meter per second to 3.5 meter per second. Means initial velocity 2.0, final velocity 3.5 meter per second. Right, time also given in how many seconds? 25 seconds. Right, these are all our given values. They are asking what is the magnitude of the force, direction of the force. Direction of the force already in the same direction of the motion of the body. It cannot be changes. Now we just need to find the force magnitude. F equal to what is the formula? Ma. Now F equal to mass into acceleration. Acceleration means change in the velocity by time. V minus u by d. Now V minus u by d means of force F equal to mass. How much given mass? Yeah, 3.0 given. Final velocity, how much given? 3.5. Yes, just I am writing 3 only, don't confuse, 3.0 means 3 only. Now 3.5 minus initial velocity, V value 2.0 by time given, time is 25 seconds. Right, now what is getting here, F equal to 3 into this value is equal to 1.5 by 25. This is 3.5 minus 2.0 is equal to 1.5. By remaining as is 25. We are multiplying also 3 into 1.5 by 25. Now here what is we are getting here, this value is equal to 4.5 by 25.
Here 4.5 by 25 means
here this is I am writing as a simple way. When removing the point, here this is I am writing here 45 into 10 power of minus 1 by 25. Here why writing like this means, listen, I am showing here, this is 4.5. 4.5 means 45 by 10, 1 after 5 is there. So 45 by 10 means taking into numerator, 45 into 10 power of minus 1. Now this is a, here 45 into 10 power of minus 1 by 25. 5 is a 25, 5 is a 45. Now what is that? 9 by 5. F equal to 9 by 5 into 10 power of minus 1. Now 5 is dividing into 9 is dividing into 5. 5 1 is 5. 0.0. 5 is 40. Now F equal to 1.8 into 10 power of minus 1. Means 1.8 by 10. 10 taking into numerator. 10 power of minus 1 is going to be 10. Means this value is equal to 0.18 newtons. 1.8 by 10 value is equal to 0.18 newtons.
Right, once again, listen.
Mass given. Here, body of mass given 3.0.
its speed is changing from 2.0 meter per second to 3.5 meter per second. Means initial speed is 2.0, final speed is 3.5 meter per second. Time given, time is how much given? 25 seconds of time is given. You know that force is equal to F is equal to, what is the formula? Force F is equal to ma. F is equal to ma into acceleration. Acceleration means a change in the velocity by time. V minus u by t. Now F is equal to mass. 3.0 means 3 I am writing simply. 3.5 minus 2.0 by 25. Now F is equal to 3 into 3.5 minus 2.0 is 1.5. 1.5 by 25. So 1.5 into 3 is equal to 4.5. 4.5 by 25. Here 4.5 I am writing here 45 into 10 power of minus 1. I am showing there by 25. Now 5 5 is 25, 5 9 is 45. Now F is equal to 9 by 5 into 10 power of minus 1. Now 9 by 5 means 9 is divided into 5. 1.8 we are getting. 1.8 into 10 power of minus 1. 1.8 by 10 power of minus 1 taking into denominator, 10 power of minus 1 becomes to be 10. 1.8 by 10 is equal to 0.18 newtons. This is what is your second question, right? Next, we go to the third question. Third question.
A body of mass 5 kg
is acted upon by two perpendicular forces.
One is the 8 Newton, another one is the 6 Newton. A body of mass 5 kg is acted upon by two perpendicular forces, 8 Newton and 6 Newton. Give the magnitude and direction of the body.
What is the magnitude and direction of the body is asking here.
Here body of mass given
m equal to, here the body of mass given here m equal to, how many kg given here? This is a 5 kg. Body of mass m equal to 5 kg is given.
Is acted upon by two forces, 8 newton and 6 newton. Give the magnitude and direction of the, what is their acceleration of the body. Here acceleration is asking magnitude and direction of the, what is the direction of the magnitude and direction of the acceleration of the body is asking.
Means the force in which direction is there, same direction acceleration is there. Just we have to find the magnitude of acceleration first of all. Now here two forces are acting perpendicularly on the body, and what is your body. Now two forces I am considering here. This is the two forces.
Here two forces I am considering. One is the 8 Newton, another one is the 6 Newton. One is I am written as a 8 Newton, 6 Newton. Both are perpendicular to each other. Means in between the angle is how many degrees? 90 degrees is there. Perpendicular. Now you magnitude and direction of the acceleration of the body. Before finding the acceleration, first we find the force. Two forces are given, 6 Newton and 8 Newton. We apply the parallelogram law. I am applying the parallelogram law. When applying the parallelogram law, now this is, yeah, this is also same value. Now what is here? This is also becomes to be how many newton? 6 newton. This is also becomes to be 8 newton. Now when applying the parallelogram law. Now what is here? This is a resultant vector. This is use of what is here? Resultant vector here. Now this is a resultant vector of these two. What is their vectors here? That resultant vector I am considering as a r. Now suppose this is a e vector. This is I am taken as a true vector. You know that here parallelogram theorem. In the parallelogram theorem, what is your resultant vector formula? R is equal to under root of p square plus q square. This is resultant vector means that gives a force here.
Now that is a t square plus 2 square plus 2 p cube cos theta. This is a 8 newton force I am taken as a vector p, 6 newton force I am taken as a vector q. This is a vector. Force nothing but a vector. So 8 newton consider as a p vector, 6 newton consider as a q vector. Means resultant vector also gives a force because of this is a resultant of two forces, 8 newton and 6 newton. So r is equal to under root of p square plus q square 2 p q cos theta. This is a resultant what is your vector, magnitude of the resultant vector formula, magnitude of the resultant vector formula. R is equal to under root of p square plus q square 2 p q cos theta. Now from this r is equal to, here what is your p value? 8 square, q value 6 square, means p value is 8 is a square is a square, q value 6 is 8, 6 square plus 2 into 8 into 6 cos theta. Theta is the angle between the two vectors. This is angle between the two vectors. Theta is about how many degrees? 90 degrees, because both are perpendicular to each other. So here what is I am writing here? This is the 2 into 8 into 6. Here cos 90 degrees. Now what is we are getting here? R is equal to, we are getting as a under root of 8 square plus 6 square plus 2 into 8 into 6 into cos 90. Sin 90 value 1, cos 90 value 0. Right. Now what is I am getting here? Resultant vector. This 8 square plus 6 square, this value becomes to be 0. Plus 0. Now r is equal to under root of 64 plus 36. Now r is equal to under root of 100. 64 plus 36 is equal to 100. Means under root of 100 is equal to 10. Means resultant vector r is equal to 10 newton. Because it is a resultant of the two vectors. What are the two vectors? We have forces. One is the 8 newton, another one is the 6 newton. So resultant vector also we get the force. That is r is equal to 10 newton. This is a resultant force. Now this is what is your resultant force. Resultant force, how many newtons we are getting here? 10 newtons. Next we find the acceleration. Mass is given already, 5 kg. Here force we know that F equal to 10 newton. Here force is equal to mass into acceleration is equal to 10. Mass is equal to 5. 5 into A equal to 10. A equal to 10 by 5 is equal to 2 meter per second square. This is negative acceleration. Next we find the directions. How find the direction of the acceleration of the body? Here when force, resultant force in which direction is there, the acceleration also in the same direction. Now resultant force we are getting here. Now this one again I am showing here. Now this is a resultant vector or the resultant force. This resultant vector is called as a force here. This is resultant vector r equal to f equal to 10 newton we are getting here. Now that resultant vector is called as a force. Now this is here I am considered as a 8 newton. This is considered as already known as 6 newton. These two are acting on a particle. Here particle is there. Now this is a, suppose it makes an angle alpha with 8 newton. Now what is the direction of the resultant force? Now what is the direction of the resultant force? How we can find here that resultant of the resultant force direction? That we find with the parallelogram law. This is resultant force r equal to f equal to 10 newton. Now this is making an alpha with 8 newton. This is the 8 newton means this is also 8 newton. This is the 6 newton means this is also 6 newton. In the parallelogram law you know that here. This is A bar, P bar means this is also P bar. This is a Q bar means this is also Q bar. Now suppose the resultant force newton, 8 newton force. It makes an angle alpha with 8 newton force. From this we find the tan alpha. It can use a direction. Tan alpha is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Tan theta means what is there? Opposite side by adjacent side means what is there? 6 by 8 here. 6 by 8 is equal to what we are getting here? 2 3s are 2 4s are 3 by 4. Means tan alpha is equal to, we are getting the 3 by 4. From this I am writing alpha is equal to tan inverse 3 by 4. This is a direction of the force, direction of the resultant force. Yeah, the direction of acceleration is also in the same direction of resultant force. So here what is here? From this we are writing here the direction of acceleration. What is here reading? Direction of acceleration. Yeah, same direction. Alpha is equal to tan inverse 3 by 2. Now suppose your angle beta is made with 6 newton. Here another way we are doing the direction. Here suppose F, a resultant vector F or R, resultant vector makes an angle beta with, yeah, beta with how many newton force here? 6 newton force. What is the direction? That is I am taking here beta angle. So here find the tan beta. In this way also we can find here. Tan beta is equal to, tan beta means opposite side by adjacent side. This is adjacent, this is opposite. So what we are getting here? 8 by 6. Here 2 3s are 2 4s are. What is we are getting? 4 by 3. So from this beta is equal to tan inverse. Okay. In this way also we can get the direction. In two ways we can represent the direction. Here in the which direction resultant force is there, in the same direction what will be there here? Acceleration. Already acceleration value how much we are getting here? 2 meter per second square we are getting. Right. This is a, here what is a third numerical. Next to we go to the fourth numerical. What is the fourth numerical is there? We will discuss that one. Right, listen. A driver of three wheeler moving with a speed of 36 km per hour sees a child standing in the middle of the road. The child is standing in the middle of the road and brings his vehicle to rest in 4.0 seconds just in time to save the child. In order to avoid the accident. Now, what is the average retarding force on the vehicle? The mass of the three wheeler is 400 kg and mass of the driver is 65 kg. First, we are find the total mass. Here, what is given here? Mass. The mass of the three wheeler is given. The mass of the three wheeler.
the mass of the three wheeler is equal to how much kg given? 400 kg given. Mass of the driver is given. Mass of the driver also given. 65 kg. Right, total mass I'm writing. I'm consider as a M. That total mass is equal to 400 plus 65. How much we are getting? We are 465 kg. This is our total mass we are getting. Now, this is our total mass we are getting. We are 465 kg. Now another one is the driver of the three wheeler is moving with a speed of 36 km per hour. Means initial speed is given u. 36 km per hour. That is converting into meter per second. How to convert here? 36 into 1. Here kilometer is equal to 1000 meters. 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. Now these two cancel. Now what is we are getting here? This is simple leg. Here 36 also cancel. Here how many meter per second here? 10 meter per second. Another one formula is also there, but I am not using that formula. 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 5/18 meter per second. Using this formula also we can find here. Right, 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 5/18 meter per second. In the place of the kilometer per hour, 5/18 we are writing. 5/18 means what is we are getting here? 5/18 means again 18. This is 18 rules we are getting, 2, 5, 6, 10. Again same value we are getting. There is no change in the value. Now this is using this also you can find here. Now this is the initial velocity is equal to 10 meter per second. The vehicle will be stopped in order to avoid the accident or in order to save the child. So stop means final velocity goes to 0. Right, automatically final velocity 0. Time given t equal to how many seconds? 4 seconds is given. Time given. Now find the force here. Force F equal to M into A, mass into acceleration. Now force F is equal to mass into acceleration. What is asking here? What is the average retarding force on the vehicle? That is asking here. Average retarding force is acting. Retarding means a minus, negative value we are getting. Now F is equal to M into V minus U by T. That is acceleration is equal to V minus U by T. Now F is equal to mass. How much mass here? That mass, total mass is equal to consider here 465 into V minus U. V is equal to what is it? 0 minus 10. U equal to 10. Now by time also given in the problem here. That is a same here time. How much given here? 4 seconds. Time given 4 seconds. Now from this we find this value F equal to minus 4650. This is a 0 minus 10. I am writing again one step here. 465 into minus 10 by 4. Now F is equal to minus 4650, 4650 by 4. Now when calculating this one value, we are getting here this value is equal to here 465 into 160. Here this is here about we are getting here 4 ones are 4, remaining is 2, 25, 4 six are 24. Remaining 1 is 8 is there, means 4 2s are 8, here 0.5. Right, once again see here, 4 1s are 4, here also 4 1s are 4, remaining 25, 4 6s are 24, next 4 2s are 8 to 0.5. Now what is we are getting here? F is equal to minus 1162.5 meters. Yeah, this is what is the retarding force. What is the retarding force on the vehicle? That retarding force on the vehicle is minus 1162.5 newtons. Here this is 1162.5 newtons we are getting here. Yeah, that is retarding force is there. So we are getting this value here. Minus value. This is the we are getting the minus value because of this is a retarding force. Right. This is your fourth numerical. First we can take the total mass.
total mass means the mass of the three wheeler and mass of the driver we can consider 465. Here it will be stopped. In order to save the child, it will be stopped means final velocity is zero. Initial velocity conversion is there. Time also given. We substitute in the force formula, we can get the final value. And final value we are getting the minus because of this is a retarding force. Right, next to yeah, we go to the next to problem.
Yeah, that is a fifth problem.
A rocket with a lift of mass
20,000 kg is blasted upwards with an initial acceleration of 5.0 meter per second square. Calculate the initial thrust of the blast. Here initial thrust means that is the force is asking. Now this is a rocket. Initial thrust means initial force. What are the initial force? This is acting in the upward direction F. Blasted upwards with initial acceleration also given. A upwards given. A equal to 5.0 meter per second square. This rocket mass also given. M equal to how much given here? The mass is equal to 20,000 kg. Now this what is here? Force. That is the force acting in the upper direction. Initial thrust is acting in the upper direction. And this moves in the initial acceleration also given 5.0 meter per second square in the upper direction. Now weight is acting in the downward direction. You know that F and Mg act in the opposite direction. Which force is larger? F is larger. Thrust is larger. So from this we know that here Newton's law of right here F minus Mg is equal to here net force. Net force means F net force can be written as a mass into acceleration. Mass I have taken as a M, acceleration I have taken as a A value also given, M value also given. First I am writing the formula. Your force F Mg, which is larger here, F is larger because acceleration in this direction. So resultant force can be written as F minus Mg is equal to mass into acceleration. Acceleration also given. Now this F is called as an initial thrust or that is called as a force. Now F equal to Mg plus Ma. Right. Now F equal to M, take the common, remaining is G plus A. Now F equal to M, mass is given, how much given? 20,000. G value near about I am considered as a 10, actual value is 9.8, but near about I am considered as a 10. Acceleration A value is equal to 5.0 means 5. Now what is the negative here from this? F is equal to 20,000 into 10 plus 5 is equal to 50. Now this is written as a 20,000 means this is I am adding 2 into 10 power of 4 into 50. 2 into 10 power of 4 into 50. 20,000 means here what is that? 10 power of 4 means 4 zeros is a 10 power of 4. Now F is equal to 52 is 30 into 10 power of 4 newtons. This is what is the initial thrust or force acting on the rocket. Right. This is a fifth problem. Next to we move through the sixth problem. Listen, this is a elevator. Here, this is already we have discussed in the theory. In this concept, the problem is there. That is what is here motion of the elevator also we have discussed here. What is the apparent weight of the person in the elevator or lift we have discussed, saying that is based on this one.
this formula is based on that concept here. Now,
a man of mass 70 kg stands on a weighing scale and means weighing machine in a lift which is moving upwards with uniform speed 10 meter per second, downwards with uniform acceleration, means one by one we will discuss. First, a man of mass given, he is standing on the weighing scale, or he is standing on a, what is a weighing machine in a lift, right? The first I am doing the gear problem, first problem here. First problem here. Now, a man of mass 70 kg, this is a weighing machine. Man of mass, already you know that here, that is having the mass 70 kg is here. Mass 70 kg means weight is in the downwards, that is a mg. Normal reaction is in the upwards. This is a normal reaction in the upward direction. Normal reaction is the apparent weight. Here, apparent mass also we have to find in each case. Now, here mass given, how much given mass? Now mass is equal to 70 kg given. Now we apply the formula. Here first condition, A problem I am doing here. In the A problem, it is moves with uniform speed. Uniform speed means it moves with uniform speed 10 meter per second. Uniform speed means V equal to 10 meter per second. V equal to constant means acceleration zero. Uniform speed means velocity is constant. Velocity constant means acceleration is zero. Here acceleration is zero means net force, how we are writing here, you know that already. Net force can be written as m minus mg equal to, it moves upwards. Upward means n is larger, n minus mg is equal to net force. Net force is equal to mass into acceleration, because it moves upward direction means acceleration is zero. Right, means this is a larger, normal reaction is larger, because it moves in the upper direction, acceleration is 0 is there, but it is acting in the upper direction. In which direction acceleration is there? That is a larger value. So m minus mg is equal to m into 0, mass into acceleration, but acceleration is 0. M minus mg is equal to m into 0, acceleration is 0. Now m minus mg equal to 0, here m equal to mg, here n equal to mg means, now n is equal to use apparent weight, mass is 70 into g value, and consider as here about 10, here this is what is here, 700 newton, this is apparent weight, this is called as apparent weight. When weight we know that, we find the what is here, I am doing here, we find the mass is equal to weight, apparent weight by g. G is a 10. We know that g value is equal to 10. We know that simply we have weight m, w is equal to mg means m required. M is equal to w by g. Right. This is a mass is equal to apparent weight by g. Now this is what is the apparent mass. Now what is here? Apparent weight is equal to how much? You know that you have 700 by g value equal to 10. Here how many kg we are getting here? 70 kg. This is apparent mass. Apparent mass and actual mass. This is the actual mass. This is what is the apparent mass. Both are the same. And the lift is moving with which speed here? Uniform speed. That uniform speed is 10 meter per second. Next, second case we will discuss. Second problem. Yeah, listen, second problem here, that is the acceleration is given 5 meter per second square. Yeah, that is the moves downwards with uniform acceleration 5 meter per second square downwards. Here in this direction, A equal to 5 meter per second square is given downward direction. Now, in this case, here what is here? Write the equation here. How to write the equation? Downwards means mg is larger because acceleration is the downward direction. So mg minus n is equal to what is that writing here? Ma. N minus mg minus n is equal to ma. From this we find the n.
mg minus ma is equal to m. Now another reaction, m equal to m into g minus a. Now normal reaction, n equal to m, mass is equal to 20,000 into g, g value is equal to 10, the acceleration value phi is given 5. Now mass is how much given? 70 given. Mass is equal to 70 given. 70 into 10 minus 5. Now what is here? N equal to mass 70 into 10 minus 5 is equal to 5. This is we are getting 350 we are getting. This is a apparent weight we are getting. N gives the apparent weight. N is equal to 350. Now this is n is equal to mg minus ma is equal to n. N equal to m into g minus a. 70 into 10 minus 5. Here so 10 minus 5 is equal to 5. 70 into 5 is equal to 350. Now apparent mass is equal to 350 by 10. Apparent weight is equal to almost 350 by g value 10. Apparent mass is equal to almost, we are getting 10 cancel 35 kg. And this is the second problem. Next, the third problem, what is given? See, here moves upwards with acceleration 5 meter per second square. Is moving upwards 5 meter per second square. Means moving upwards means how to write the equation, which is the larger. Normal reaction is larger in comparison to mg. Now because it is moving in the upper direction, which direction acceleration is a, that force is larger. We know that that concept. Now what is here? M minus mg equal to ma. So n equal to ma plus mg, or n equal to r mg plus ma, you can write here mg plus ma. Now n equal to m, take the common g plus a, you can write here. Now n equal to mass is equal to 70 given g value equal to 10, acceleration is equal to 5. Now n equal to 70 into 1050, simply 1050 newtons we are getting. Now 1000, here this is the apparent mass of, we are finding apparent weight is 1050 by 10. Here this one is cancelled. How many newtons here? 105 newtons. We are getting here that value is equal to, here how many newtons we are getting here? 105 newtons. Ready? This is the third problem. Next we will discuss the D. What would be the reading if the lift mechanism failed and is uttered down freely under gravity? Means it is freely falling. Freely falling means what is the zero? Acceleration is zero. Find here. Freely falling in the downward direction because lift is failed. And lift is failed, it is falling under the gravity only. Means under the gravity means A value is not zero. A value equal to G. Now find here, under gravity it is falling down. Now because here acceleration is equal to G, which force is larger? M is larger, N is larger, because acceleration in the downward direction, it is falling towards the ground. So here MG is larger. Here Y A equal to G, I am taken freely falling. Freely falling means acceleration is equal to the acceleration due to gravity. G is called as a acceleration due to gravity. Now which force is larger? MG is larger. So how write the equation here? Mg minus n equal to ma. Here a equal to g. So what is we are getting here? This is mg minus ma is equal to m into g. In the place of the a, I am writing as a g. Now from this, here mg minus mg is equal to m. Now mg minus mg is equal to m means n value is equal to what is here? 0. Means apparent weight value is equal to 0. Mg minus mg is equal to 0. Apparent weight is equal to 0 means here 0 by 10. Apparent mass 0 by 10 is equal to how much we are getting? Something. 0 by something is equal to 0. 0 kg. Means apparent mass is equal to 0. Here actual mass is 17 is there, but apparent mass is 0. When here what is the lift is falling freely under the gravity. Because apparent weight is zero. Normal reaction is zero means apparent weight is zero. Apparent weight is zero means apparent mass also zero. Okay, remaining numericals we will discuss in the next class. Okay, thank you.